Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. Stick around to the end and you'll find out why I'm wearing these glasses to do this video this week. Well, let's start and waste no time by talking about Apple's WWDC 2024, where they announced iOS 18 and macOS Sequoia. It's going to be really interesting, particularly the ability to use Apple Intelligence. You'll be able to do all kinds of things as a content creator, such as generating images. I'm not so sure the feature about generating an image of your mum looking like a superhero is going to be well used, but it's going to be built into all the apps, so you can generate images much like many of the other AI image generators out there. There's also great features such as the image wand, which will improve or create images around your content with the context of what you've written. Plus, you'll be able to use features such as Genmoji, which uses generative AI to create emojis that express yourself, such as a cooking cat, should you want such a feature. You can clean up photos and craft stories. Where this is really important is you can use Apple's intelligence to find photos that tell a story and build something for Instagram, YouTube Shorts, and so on. And if you have trouble writing things, as often I do, you'll be able to rewrite things, particularly when you're writing emails and you want to get the tone exactly right. And if you're not sure about something you've written out, you want to have it checked, Apple will proofread your stuff as well. I'm really excited about the notifications as well. I get too many of them. Well, you'll get priority notifications and Apple Intelligence will summarize things that are important to you. And finally, for my quick content creator roundup, well, I only used Siri in the past to set timers, but now it looks like it's getting better. And what's more, it's getting an integration with ChatGPT where you can ask it a question and it will privately send that message off to OpenAI to give you the best possible answer. And of course, privacy was a big thing on Apple's mind, where they show most of the processing will be done with just the data it needs at one time on your device, and when it needs to go into the cloud, they're taking privacy very, very seriously. Although I do wonder about this meme that featured Craig's reaction to where the training data came from for Apple Intelligence. All right, let's move on to Luma Labs and their AI dream machine. This really did blow up the internet and had a few eyes popping out of sockets, as we'd been waiting a while for OpenAI's Sora to be released. And last week I spoke about Kaiyushu's Kling, which is a Chinese video generator. But now Dream Machine has made realistic video generation in high quality from text and images available to anyone for free. With their freemium model, you can do 30 free generations a month and take a look at some of the stuff I generated. In order to do it, just use the link down below and click try now. And then you can see here, I've got 30 free generations each month, but if you want to pay from around $30, you can get 120 generations per month, $100, 400 generations per month, and 2,000 generations a month for $500. So it quickly gets more expensive depending on how many generations you want to do per month. Some of the generations were better than others. Here's a high angle shot of a wizard casting a powerful spell in an ancient forest with glowing runes swirling around him. Well, it paid attention to most of that prompt, but maybe not all of it. It does look very realistic. Then we got this close-up shot of a modern-day man enjoying a slice of pizza. Yeah, that's pretty AI generated, but you know what? It's not bad at all. I also made this generation as an alternative, which is also a lot of fun. As you can see, to use it once you've signed up, you just type in words or upload an image and get started. So generations are taking around 120 seconds, but due to high demand at the moment, they might take a bit longer. So I've uploaded an image of me here, a man turning into an alien. Okay, let's run that prompt and see what comes back. Now notice there's enhanced prompt down here. The AI will do some further magic, but if you want it to be strictly prompt adherent, you may want to consider unticking that box. I'll leave it ticked and generate. Now, if you're enjoying what you see so far, do throw a like on this video and remember to subscribe to my channel, because every single week I bring you the latest AI tools I found that I think will be extremely useful for you in your content creation journey. While we wait for that to generate, let's look at a few more generations I made earlier, such as this wide angle shot of a grand wizard's jewel on a mountain peak. Pretty dramatic if you ask me. Then there's this reference photo of me sitting in an armchair getting shot by a bolt of fire and going into a different world. Quite interesting there. Interestingly, it doesn't always pay attention to the prompt. I said a man raising his hands to a stormy sky with lightning bolts. Instead, I just got a video of me talking, which actually looks scary realistic. I got it to animate the logo for Creator Magic. I actually think it did a pretty good job with this. It can also do different styles. Well, I thought this was good, a cyberpunk-inspired scene of futuristic mage hacking into a virtual realm. Then I tried man turns into a cat, but instead of turning into a cat, I was kind of manhandling a cat. I had a go at a Minecraft-inspired prompt, a wizard crafting a powerful potion in a blocky enchanted lab. That one's nice. Finally, me turning into an alien. Yeah. Maybe not. All right, go and have a play with Luma Labs AI Dream Machine. I think it's pretty fantastic. I'll link to it down below, as I will everything else I show you in this video. Let's move on to image generation. And we looked at Stable Diffusion 3 a while back, but I got an email. The waits are here. Stable Diffusion 3 Medium is officially out and ready to download. You can run this locally on your own computer. Now, why would you want to use this as opposed to DALL-E or Midjourney? Well, obviously it's an open model, so anyone can use it, and you don't have to pay if you're using it on your own system. It's got advanced photorealism, good typography, and prompt adherence. And if you don't want to install it on your local device, you just want to test it out in the cloud, good news, Fireworks AI have added Stable Diffusion 3 Medium to their available models. All you need to do is sign up for an account with Fireworks AI and grab your Stability AI API key, making sure you've got some credits. Usually you get some for free when you sign up. I'm going to copy my API key in. We'll change the output format to JPEG and the aspect ratio to 16:9. And let's run a few test prompts. First, let's go with something really simple. Three parrots with umbrellas. And there we go. Okay, the umbrellas were a bit glitchy, but there are definitely three parrots there. Note also, this is a pretty cheap model to run, even in the cloud, with just over 3 cents per image generation. Next up, we're going to try some typography, and I've got a photo of audio cables shaped as letters to make the words AI is the future. Not too bad. I mean, that's pretty much the closest it gets, but yeah, need some work there with the typography and text prompt adherence. Okay, for this final one, I'm going to do a photo of three magic bottles in a wizard's den. The first is yellow with the label audio, second one orange with the label video, and third one red with the label text. And hey, that's probably the best generation so far. Yeah, again, it's absolutely crushing it with the prompt adherence on both the text and the image and the detail of the color of the bottles. I'm impressed. This one looks really good. Seems to favor apples, but I guess we can use negative prompts to change that. So in the negative prompt, I'm going to put apples. Ah, marvelous. Not a single apple in sight in that fruit bowl. So there you go, Stable Diffusion 3 Medium. You can download the weights and try it on your own super powerful GPU-enhanced computer, or you can try it in the cloud using Fireworks AI with a Stability API key. Go and test it out. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And now finally, why am I wearing these Ray-Ban Meta smart glasses? Well, the reason is I'm getting really excited about Meta AI here in the UK where I am, although I didn't have it. Some reported on forums accidental launches of this feature. Even this Tech Radar article from this week, written by a UK journalist, says they have it, but I don't. I started to get really annoyed by this and all the beautiful AI features that I just can't use here right now. So I actually went to Grok from X and asked Grok, how can I get Meta AI in the UK? And it told me to just try searching for an update, of which there were none. And then it said, if you don't get it via an update, you can try a US or Canadian VPN. So I did that and instantly in my app got update 5.1 instantly downloaded to my glasses, but still no Meta AI. So how did I finally get it? Well, I stayed connected to the US VPN, disconnected entirely my glasses, didn't need to reset them, just disconnected the Bluetooth, reconnected them again via the app, and lo and behold, Meta AI was activated. It works here where I am in the UK, and it's awesome. You will note that on the Ray-Ban website, these Meta AIs are actually available in the UK, even at UK prices, despite not having the AI features rolled out fully yet. Vision is probably the best feature, and I want to show you a few examples. Okay, so it's really good at translating German, French, Spanish, and Italian. Great if you're going on a holiday. Let's try it out with this sign on a beach. I've no idea what it says, but Meta AI will. Hey Meta, look and tell me what this sign says.
The sign says, plage interdite aux chiens, which means beach forbidden to dogs in English.
Isn't that brilliant? Now I'm never going to make a mistake on a French beach again. Hey Meta, look and tell me what this sign says.
The sign says, no pedestrians.
Hey Meta, look and translate this sign word for word.
in case of vigilance, submersion waves.
Okay, as you can see, if I ask it to literally translate a sign, it's not so good, but it can give me the context of things in many different languages, and I like that. It's going to be great for the holidays this year. Let's move on to this picture. Hey Meta, look and tell me what the breed of this dog is.
The dog appears to be a Springer Spaniel.
And it's absolutely right. Our beloved Springer Spaniel there. Hey Meta, look and tell me what emotional state this person is in.
The person appears to be in a neutral or calm emotional state.
Interesting. So it can actually look at people and tell you their emotions. That's a pretty cool AI feature. Finally, let's finish up with a German pizza menu and see if it can help me out. Hey Meta, look and recommend the healthiest thing on this menu to me.
I recommend the margarita pizza. It's a classic and healthy option with fresh tomatoes, mozzarella cheese, and basil.
Tell me what's in the tonno pizza.
The tonno pizza has tomatoes, mozzarella cheese, and tuna.
So I've got to say, not only did it get me the ingredients from that pizza, but it also corrected my pronunciation of the pizza to save me embarrassment with the waiter or waitress when they come around. And finally, a good old classic use case. Hey Meta, look and tell me the history behind this landmark.
The Taj Mahal was built by Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan in memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal, who died during childbirth. It took over 22 years to complete and is considered one of the most beautiful examples of Mughal architecture.
There we go, pretty cool. The Meta Ray-Ban glasses. I've been recommending these for a while. I bought them back at the start of this year when I was at the CES conference in Las Vegas back in 2024. But now, thankfully, they're available in many other locations around the world. And you can get Meta AI, even if you have to use a little bit of advice from Grok. But here it is on my phone, ready and activated. And you can choose through different voices in the Meta AI option. I do like the fact that there's a bunch of different selections there, including American, British, Australian, even French and Italian as well. I gotta say, after going through all of them, I went to the Australian voice. I thought that was the nicest and softest voice. And frankly, actually, I thought the UK voices sounded like rather strict school teachers. So it just depends what you're looking for. But those Ray-Ban Meta sunglasses have some super cool AI features packed in, and I've been using on and off for a while to take photos and videos when out on walks, on holidays, and with the addition of vision and the ability in the recent update to upload your images automatically to Instagram, I really think these glasses are a game changer. Thanks for watching this week's roundup of all the AI tools that are exciting me in content creation. I hope they excite you too. Go and check the back catalog by watching the video on your screen or the videos down below in the description. And remember, the Creator Magic podcast is available. Go and subscribe to that. I had Greg Priest on this week, and he gave an awesome automation workflow for video production.